See children, all of you, good evening. See, yesterday we discussed about the zeros of the quadratic polynomial and sum of the zeros and product of zeros, and we compared both with the coefficients of that equation, quadratic equation. Today we are going to see how to form a quadratic equation. We have some of the zeros we have and product of the zeros we have. How to form a quadratic equation? See, if alpha comma beta are the zeros of the quadratic polynomial, if these two are zeros of this particular quadratic polynomial, that is ax square plus bx plus c, this is equation, a polynomial, quadratic polynomial, then x minus alpha. See, here alpha is 0 means x minus alpha is the factor. Next, beta is 0 means x minus beta are the factors of p of x. Then the quadratic equation we can write in this way. K means constant. K into, what are the factors? X minus alpha, x minus beta. These two are the factors of this particular equation. Let us just assume. Next, multiply these two. Do two factors, x into x, x square, x into beta, x beta. Next, minus is there, so minus symbol will come, x into minus beta, minus x beta. Next, alpha into x, that is minus alpha into x, minus x alpha, minus into minus, plus, and alpha into beta, alpha beta. So if you take x as common in these two, in these two terms, if you take x as common, see, minus x I took as common. So if I take minus x as common, here beta is there and alpha is there. In between, minus is there already. That's why minus into minus plus, it becomes plus. That's why alpha plus beta is the middle term. And the last term is x, alpha into beta is the last term. See, k is there. K is a constant. If you multiply both, complete equation with kx square minus kx into alpha plus beta plus k into alpha beta. Now if you compare these two equations, coefficients of the x square coefficient, if you take x square coefficient a and x coefficient b, next constant term, if you compare these two equations, this equation and this equation, both are equal, if you compare, what will happen? A is equals to K. What about B? B is equals to alpha plus beta. K is constant, for all it will come. Alpha plus beta into K. Next, C is equals to constant means K into some constant will be there. And alpha into beta, product of the two zeros. Product of the zeros of the polynomial. Now, how to find the sum? Alpha plus beta. This alpha plus beta is equals to, yesterday we already discussed about the coefficients, how minus x, coefficient of x by coefficient of x square, minus coefficient of x b by, what is the x square coefficient? A. That's why minus b by a. Simply just remember, no need to write minus coefficient of x by coefficient of x square, no need to write that one, just you have to keep it in mind, minus b by a, because we are comparing these both equations. Next, alpha beta, product of the zeros is equals to constant term, no need to write full form constant, here constant is c, that's why I took as c, by coefficient of x square. What is the coefficient of x square? A. That's why I wrote a. Yesterday we discussed everything. Instead of writing that minus coefficient of x by coefficient of x square, just I wrote minus b by a. In this way, we will find out now, they will give you the sum of the zeros and product of the zeros. See, page number 63, example 5. If you observe example 5, page 63, example 5. If you see that one, see, find the quadratic polynomial, the sum and product of whose zeros are minus 3. He has given sum. sum he has given minus 3, product also he has given. What is product? 2. If you add 2 zeros of the polynomial, you will get minus 3. If you multiply, you will get 2. Both he has given, and he asked you to find out quadratic polynomial. How to form a quadratic polynomial or equation?